Hello students, so we'll move on with the next example. That is a program which is associated with the cookies, and this is also your third A lab program. Okay, that is a program to store current date time in a cookie and display the last visited on. So when was the page last visited? Okay, date time on the web page upon reopening the same page. So when you reopen the page once again, it should tell you or it should display when was a page last opened. Okay, so I hope you remember cookie. So what do you mean by a cookie is, this is the information that is stored at the client end. Okay, so session when you say, that will be at the server end, whereas cookie will be at the client browser. Okay, so we said that in PHP we can set a cookie by using a function called as set cookie. So we'll just see the program. So here, okay, we'll come to the set cookie function. So what does the set cookie do? Set cookie can either set, or in other way you can say create a cookie. Okay, so this particular function, in this the first parameter is a compulsory one, whereas others are optional one. Okay, so the first parameter here is going to tell you the name of the cookie. So the name of the cookie is visit date. And the next parameter is going to tell you, or we are using the date function. Okay, so the date function, you are passing some parameter wherein this capital G is representing a 24 hours, the format is representing 24 hours, whereas I is representing minutes, S is indicating seconds, and this A is nothing but it is going to tell you whether it is AM or PM. Okay, followed by that you have date, month and year. So here year I have given as I have given Y in capital because I want it as 2020. If you give in lowercase, only difference is it will display as 20. Okay, it's not a four digit, only two digits will be displayed. Okay, so that is a second parameter, that is nothing but it is the value. Okay, what value will be there in this cookie, that is this date. And the third parameter is nothing but it is going to tell you the time. So we are setting the time. So we'll come back here. So what is the time we have set? We need this cookie to be present in our browser for 60 days. Okay, we'll assign it as 60 days this particular cookie should be present in our browser. So for that purpose, we are using a function called as time. So this time function, what does it do? It is going to give us the current time. Okay, plus, so when you say plus, from the current time what and all needs to be added? This is 60 days, we said 60 days, so it is 60 days, 24 hours, 60 minutes and 60 seconds. So all these are nothing but the value that is stored in your number of days. So number of days here, what we are telling, it should be there for 60 days in our system. Next we'll see the isSet function. So isSet function, what does it do is, it is going to check for your session variable, or here in this case your cookie array. Here this first time when you are visiting this particular page, this variable visit date, obviously it will be null because it is not yet visited. So that time what will happen is, you're going to get a message as please set the cookie. Okay, next time when you refresh that particular page, it will be having some value. Okay, because you have already visited it once. So that time what it is going to give you, since it is have returning some value, so visit date, so that value is your visit date. What will be there in that? It will be having the date, okay, as well as time of last visit. So what you're going to print that? So when you're printing, you're just doing some alignment, that is center tag as well as bold. So what you're typing here, that is your last visit was, will be in bold, and in the last visit in this particular variable, what you'll have, you will have the date as well as time when this particular page was last visited. So this is your 3A program, okay, and an example program for cookie. So we'll just execute this and see, that is set date. Okay, I'll go in for set date. So localhost slash set date dot php. Okay, so you can see first time when we execute this particular program, we got it as please set the cookie. Why? Because initially it will be null. Okay, next time you refresh it, so you're getting some time. Okay, so every time you refresh, the value will be changed. This is your program. Okay, you here, even here you can check the cookie. You can go for settings and you can go for content. You can see the cookie present with the name what you have given. So see all cookies. So again, you have to go to localhost. You have to go to localhost. Okay, you have one cookie created, that is visited. So just see here, now you don't have that PHP session. Why you don't have that session? Because we have not used session start function that we had used in the previous session, wherein after that I've closed the browser. So here you just have a cookie whose name is visit date. You had given the name as visit date, followed by that. Again, in this case, a session ID is created. Okay. You have the name as visit date and you have the content. That is the content of the cookie. So what we have to see here is, in the cookie, you had given a time. You had given a time. What was that time? 60 days from today. So just check whether that time is same. 60 days from today. So today, if I'm saying it as 20 April and the time is 6:32:53 PM, 60 days, that is April, May, June. Okay, so 60 days this cookie will be there in my browser. Okay, after that it will be deleted. If I want, I can delete on my own, so then it will be deleted. Otherwise, if I'm not doing any modification, this cookie will be there for 60 days. So this is an example program for cookie. Okay, so I hope you have understood this. Thank you.